symbol of apostrophe. So your apostrophe looks like this. So this is the apostrophe. So when do we use this apostrophe? When do we use this apostrophe? What it indicates? I will tell you now. See, you use this apostrophe to show the possession or to show the ownership. That time we use this apostrophe to show the possession of anything. So like this, to show the possession, we use this apostrophe. Possession is nothing but ownership. Okay. Suppose I say this is a duster. This belongs to me. So this is teacher's duster. That is, this duster is mine, isn't it? So this is teacher's. So how do you write this teacher's? I will tell you. So to show the possession, mainly we use this apostrophe, and we write this apostrophe at the top of the word. Okay. Now I will give you some examples. Suppose I will say elephant. Okay, elephant trunk. So I want to tell that elephant has got or elephant possesses a trunk. So how do I write this? Elephants. Yes, I add. In between T and S, I add apostrophe. That is, it is elephant's trunk. So the trunk belongs to whom? Yes, we don't have trunk, isn't it? Do we have trunk? No. So it is elephant's trunk. So the trunk belongs to whom? The trunk belongs to elephant. And elephant is a singular, isn't it? Elephant is singular. So we use apostrophe in between here, like this. You can see here. Here we use the apostrophe and we write apostrophe after S to show the possession. One more example. Let us see. B-O-Y, pencil, P-E-N-C-I-L. So, the pencil belongs to boy. This one pencil is there. So, that pencil belongs to boy. So, how do we write that? Instead of writing in a big sentence, this is this boy's pencil, we will write it in a short way. See, apostrophe and S. So, boy's pencil. Boy's pencil. This pencil belongs to whom? Yes, this boy. So, to show the possession, we use this apostrophe. We also can write girls. We write apostrophe here. Girls frock. F-R-O-C-K. Frock. So, the frock belongs to whom? This girls. You can observe that here elephant, boy and girl. Everything is in singular. That is one. So how to use for plurals? Sometimes we have to show the plural form also possession, isn't it? So how to use plural forms apostrophe? I will tell you. How to use for, this is for singular. Okay, this is for singular. This is for singular. So for plural, how do we use the apostrophe? So elephant is singular, boy is singular, girl is also singular. You can also write child's toy. For example, child is only one, isn't it? C-H-I-L-D, child. Apostrophe, yes, child's toys, T-O-Y-S. So, whose toys, these toys belong to whom? Yes, these toys belongs to the child, a particular child. So, we write that child's toys, these toys belong to child. So, to say, instead of saying that these toys belong to the child, we write it as child's toys. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now, suppose we have something to for plurals. Plurals. So how to use it? Use the apostrophe for plurals. Suppose I want to say that this is now we have boy here only single. Now I write that boys ball. So here B-O-Y-S, it shows the plural form, isn't it? Singular form is only B-O-Y, boy. But here B-O-Y-S, boys is the plural form. And I want to tell that this ball belongs to all the boys. Okay, not one boy. This ball belongs to all the boys. So instead, you cannot write that boys apostrophe S. Yes. This is wrong. Because double S, it doesn't look good and it doesn't sound good also. So you cannot write like this. Since boys for plural forms you have to write the apostrophe, you cannot write boys ball. This is wrong. So how can you write for that? It is very simple, children. Sorry. B-O-Y. After the S, you are going to give the apostrophe. That's it. So there is no confusion and there is no one more S required. There is no one more S required. So boys after S you have to put here between the, before the S you are writing the apostrophe, but here after the S you are writing and you have only one S, only single S. You are not writing any double S here. So after the S you will write this. So now boys ball, that is this ball belongs to all the boys. Maybe they are football players or they are volleyball players or they are basketball players. So players are many, isn't it? So boys ball means this balls belong to all the boys. Got it? Now I will give you one more example. Now teacher is a singular, isn't it? Teacher is singular. I am singular. Suppose if you have another two teachers beside me, math teacher and some science teacher standing beside me, you call it as teachers. But now I am only one, so you can call me teacher, isn't it? Suppose I am writing something, some board, I want to write teachers. So that is group of teachers. This belongs to group of teachers. So how do I tell that? Teachers. T-E-A-C-H-E-R. Teacher is a singular. Names I write. Okay, name. N-E-A-N-E-S. Teacher name. That is clear. Teacher name is name of a teacher. But I want to tell the names of teachers, that is plural, more than one teacher or the group of teachers. So how do I tell that these names are our teachers? So plural form is teachers, isn't it? Teachers name. So these names are teachers name. Our lesson. So what do we write? After the S we will put a apostrophe. Understood? After the the apostrophe. We will not write one more S. This is wrong. Teachers. It becomes teachers' name. That is wrong. So you cannot write like that. So this is wrong. So when we have S at the end, that is for the plural, after the S, we will write the apostrophe. So this is the basic rule for your apostrophe. So I want to say that you will see that Skylarks, S-K-Y-L-A-R-K, Skylark boys. So I want to tell this is different. Don't confuse, this is different. Skylark boys. So this boys belong to Skylark. How do I say that? Yes, you have to put an apostrophe here and write S. Then it becomes Skylark's voice. Skylark's voice. That is, this voice belongs to Skylark. So like this, for singular, you have to first write the apostrophe at the top and then you have to write the S. But for plurals, after the S, only one S you have to write and you will write the apostrophe after the S. Got it? So suppose we have children. Children is the plural form of the child, isn't it? Children. C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N. Children is plural. So here the plural form is not ending with any S. Is it ending with any S? No. But children is a plural form. So for this you can write apostrophe S. Children's. Yes, games you can write. Games, that is, the games belong to all the children, not one child. The games belong to all the children. So the plurals that end with S, you need not write one more S. After writing the S, you have to put the apostrophe to show the possession. For plurals which doesn't end with S, like children, you need not write S and then write apostrophe. You can write like this, children's game, because children is already a plural form. So only for the plural forms that end with S, you have to write the apostrophe after the S. I hope, children, this is clear to you. So we will first solve the second standard children and third standard children. Please solve the work in your textbook. So second standard children, on page number 50, you have the description about the apostrophe, and on page number 51, you have A main to complete using apostrophe S. So you have to complete this. Okay, children? Yes. And third and fourth standard children also, you refer the index page here. You will get the apostrophe belongs to which lesson. You search from here apostrophes and you write the apostrophe in your textbook itself. Okay, children? I think it is clear. So second standard children, please solve page number 51, A main. In your textbook itself, you have to solve. Okay, children, I hope that you understood the concept. I will see you in the next class. Thank you, children.